Okay, I want to talk for a couple of minutes about functions and domain and range. Because I'm trying to think of a simple example. Let's say you have a turtle who's walking at a rate of 1 mile per hour. And we're going to be measuring this according to, say, highway markers. So let's say you're at the beginning of a freeway. The turtle starts at zero and zero here. And this will be hours. And this will be miles. So for hours, we'll go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And for miles, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And so the distance traveled in miles is a function of hours. So the turtle's walking at 1 mile per hour. So in 1 hour, the turtle would have gone 1 mile. In 2 hours, would have gone 2 miles. In 3 hours, would have gone 3 miles. 4 hours, 4 miles. 5 hours, 5 miles. And we're assuming constant rate. Okay, now I just use these points to help visualize the pattern, but really since it's a constant rate and the turtle could be at any distance at any time, in other words, if the turtle was at half an hour, it would be half a mile. Quarter hour, quarter mile. 1 1/8 hour, 1 1/8 mile, and so on and so forth. So this is a continuous function, and that means that there are no breaks. And so the turtle is walking continuously along, and then the distance is increasing as well. Okay, now let's talk about domain. Now for a continuous function, I need to use set notation. And the reason why is there is an infinite number of points on each line. And we need to represent all these points, and we can't list them all, so we use set builder notation. So x is defined as a real number, and if you have a continuous function, it has to be real numbers, otherwise you would have breaks in between. And so this turtle starts at marker 0 and continues up to marker 5. So I have the domain is 0 to 5 hours. So the turtle starts at 0 hours and continuously walks for 5 hours. So I have the domain is greater than or equal to 0, less than or equal to 5, and here's how you read it. X is an element of the real numbers such that, which is what that vertical bar means, X is greater than or equal to 0 and less than or equal to 5. There's your set builder notation domain. Now let's talk about the range. And the turtle starts at mile 0 and continuously walks to mile 5. So y, an element of the real numbers, such that y is greater than or equal to 0, less than or equal to 5. And again, because this was a continuous function, I have to use set builder notation to show all the points that are inputs and outputs. Okay, now let's look at the turtle situation from a different point of view. Now let's say instead of distance versus time, we have mile markers versus time. Now, mile markers are those numbers you see on the side of the freeway, and they count up. Each mile has a different marker. So let's say we're starting at the beginning of the freeway, and it's at marker 0. In 1 hour, the turtle's at marker 1. In 2 hours, the turtle's at marker 2. In 3 hours, 3, and so on and so forth, up through marker 5. What happens at half an hour? Well, there's no mile marker there. That's not part of the function. See, the function is only defined as these discrete inputs and outputs. This is called a discrete function. And a discrete function is just based on a set of points that are not continuous. So it's just individual points that you're picking here. Okay, so how do you write the domain for this type of situation where there are no numbers in between, you just have discrete function here? Well, you have two different options. First option is just listing the inputs and outputs, and that's really the most practical way to go. So the domain inputs are the integers from 0 to 5, so I just listed those integers. And for the range, The outputs are 0 through 5 as well, so I'm just going to list those outputs. Okay, there's the domain and range. Can you use set builder notation for a discrete function? Sure you can. It's going to look a little different, and sometimes it's more work than it's really worth doing. But in this situation, x is an element of the integers, which is represented by a letter z, and you can thank the Germans for that. And you can say that so you can say like that. X is an element of the integers, which is letter z, such that x is greater than or equal to 0, less than or equal to 5. That's how you would define the integers between 0 and 5, including 0 and 5. And this looks kind of cool if you understand the notation, but it's really more work than you need, especially if you only have a few inputs. What's the point, you know? But you can use set builder notation. And I'll bet you could extend this into the range as well if you wanted to. You could just say y is an element of the integers and say y is greater than or equal to 0, less than or equal to 5. But you really, like I said, this is really more work than you need to make it. Okay, so there it is. Okay, I'm going to look at one more function situation. Now for this function, let's talk about money. Let's say I have a handful of nickels, and I want to know how much they're worth in cents. So you're going to have the cents as a function of the number of nickels. So we'll start at 0, 0 again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And this is nickels. And going up here, this will be the cents. So if I have 0 nickels, I have 0 cents. If I have 1 nickel, that's going to be 5 cents. If I have 2 nickels, that's going to be 10 cents. And 3, 15, and so on and so forth. But I've run out of room on the graph. I think this is enough to illustrate the point, though. So let's say I have 5 nickels, and I'm going up to 25 cents. So my inputs just like that. And this is very similar to the turtle situation that we were just talking about. What about the outputs? Well, those only go by fives. So it'd be 0, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. So that would be the range. That's assuming you're going all the way to 25. Let me make a quick table of values just so you can see. And if the graph grid was a little bit bigger, I would have continued making the graph. But so let's say we'll put N for nickels and then C for cents. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 0, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. Okay, so now you can see all the values that were used for the domain and range. Notice the values in the table are the same as the domain and range notation here. And this is a discrete function. There are gaps in between. I mean, if you have half a nickel, you're not going to have 2.5 cents. You know, that doesn't fit the situation. So we're only using these discrete points. So what about set builder notation? Well, you could do the 1 through 5 for the domain, but then with the range, it gets complicated because you're going by fives. You can't just say it's an element of the integers. You'd have to talk about how the integers are a multiple of 5. And really, that's more complicated than what we want to get into at this level. So I would say just write it this way for domain and range. When you have a discrete situation. If you have continuous, you have to use set builder notation for the reasons I talked about, but for discrete math, write it like this. So the function tells you what notation to use, and you want to keep that in mind as you're working with functions and defining domain and range.